Hey fellow Vault Dwellers, it's Angry Turtle, and as I promised, I'm coming with a guide for the Colossal Problem, the event that will actually start tomorrow. Then it's a fair warning here, if you don't want to know anything about this event and you want to experience it blind, then don't watch this guide just yet. Wait like 2-3 days when event will be live and you'll be able to test it by yourself. Otherwise, you're welcome to stay and check out this guide. But before we start, I would like to welcome my latest Patreon, Joe H. Welcome into Turtles Army. I truly appreciate your support. Thank you for joining the Patreon. And now, how to start the event. It's getting started by dropping a nuke. Similarly to Scotch Biscuit, we just nuke a different spot. When you open the map, you look for Monunga Mine. And you need to nuke this mine. And actually, it doesn't really matter where you nuke around it. There is nothing interesting apart from the Colossal Problem. Unless you figure out something, then let me know. But you can basically nuke directly, as when event will appear, you will fast travel to the event anyway. You do not need to have like any fast travel spot inside. Therefore, you just nuke the mine. And now a little bit about the gear that I would advise to use. Generally, I noticed that the best for this event is either Bloodied Unarmed, tanky version, not the sneaky one really, and Bloodied Power Armor Heavy Gunner. That's top two picks for me. I tried it as well with Full Health Heavy Gunner. Unfortunately, that was a disaster and a failure. There was not enough damage, even though I had like two other people with me. Full health builds as well, and we failed. We did damage, we almost killed the boss, but it took us over 30 minutes, and if you do not kill the boss in 30 minutes, you will get kicked out from the mine, and event will fail, and you have nothing. Then what I'm using at this moment, I have with me Prime Bloodied 50 cal, I have Bloodied Faster Fire Rate, Gauss Minigun, it's primed as well, and it's 3-barreled, and those are the most powerful mods. I'm not using any magic, I'm just using full power of these weapons. And for healing, I have Vampire Minigun, but it's not modded for magic, it's modded for Prime as well. Then it's what I recommend. At least one vampire weapon on you is very handy. If you need some extra healing and don't want to waste stims, going Bloodied build and Vampire weapon is very valuable option. It's way better than going full health build and using powerful weapon like Furious. Even though it will work well, full health and Furious, but damage will be way too low. Then Vampire and Bloodied is more damage than full health and damage focused weapon. Now my second recommendation, as on this event you need to be tanky, I really recommend you to use whatever can boost your maximum HP. Some people will tell you that boosting your maximum HP is worthless, but that's not true. Boosting your maximum HP, even if you are Bloodied build, it's the best way to becoming more tanky when playing Bloodied build. It allows you to still dish out a lot of damage and be tanky. Then what I'm using the perk under Charisma that boosts my alcohols. Therefore, Vodka is giving me 75 extra HP. I have only 2 in here, then this will not last too long, but I have nice supply of Psycho Buff that gives additional 65 HP on top of everything. I haven't got time to craft any food that will give me additional HP, then that will need to do. And event pop up on the map. There is usually no rush, but there is one thing you need to know. This event is limited to 8 person per instant. After first instant will be full, the second one will get started, and people joining after first one is full will end up on the second instance. And if nothing changed from when I was testing it last time, it can happen that your teammates will end up in different instance than you. Then that's odd, but maybe it will be fixed, or maybe it's fixed already. I have no way to test at this moment. As you can see, I'm alone. There's no one on this server. And why I said you do not need to rush, if you are able to solo this event, there is like 5 minute waiting time, then you will not be late. Let's go anyway. And we are already inside. There's a lot of workbenches inside as well. Then if you forgot to like craft your ammo, there's ammo workbench, weapon armor workbench, chemistry workbench, then the basic supply you shouldn't be worried about. And if you don't feel like you can solo this event, then you should click on the marker of this event and join as soon as this will appear on the map, because it's the only way that you will be first and you will join actually the full event rather than almost empty one. And good thing about those Wendigo spawns, they actually drop ammo that you kill them with. Not every time, but a lot of them drop this ammo, then you will get some of the ammo back, and that's other benefits of being bloodied build. You will spend less bullets and it's not determined how much you shoot it. It's just random amount of ammo from those Wendigo. And even though they are looking like glowing, they're not glowing, the glow sight will not boost your damage in here. And that's the waiting area. I will just wait for this rubble to disappear. And as you can see, I still have 1 minute 40 seconds. And I will not cover any lore connected to this event in this video. It was already covered by other YouTubers. I just don't like to give you spoilers that you maybe do not want. And when this event will get live, it's like not too long quest, like a side quest connected to this event that you can do by yourself to discover what happened in the mine exactly. And rubble clear up. We can jump into this event. If you do not have a power armor, don't jump straight down, because it's quite a huge jump, unless you want to use Revenant and you have a friend that will revive you after jumping. But I can jump in. And here, in the mine, that's a battlefield. When we are fighting the boss, you can see him over there, the end of the screen. He's just eating. And before I go to him, those drills that's sticking out from the walls, if you touch them, it's doing a lot of damage. Okay, first let's boost me and let's see if I can touch them a little bit. You see? Oh, stuck. And I'm dead. Yeah, exactly. It's doing a lot of damage, and that's basically a true damage. Then you need to be very careful to do not run into it. And it seems easy, but it's not so easy. You need to be aware where are you, because Wendigo Colossus is using this scream that fear you and you run away from him. Therefore, you can end up on those drills and kill yourself. And there is more area of effect. Sometimes there is like ceiling falling down and it's doing a lot of damage as well. Other damage like radiation and stuff like that is less significant. And as you can see, he's crazy tanky. I'm not doing too much damage. I have too much health at this moment, but this will fix itself. And he's throwing this poisonous area as well. Those doing damage too and slow you down. As you can see, it slows you down a lot. And it's doing like medium damage, it's not too much damage. And he's summoning his helpers. And it's actually good to loot them, as they drop you screws and some of them will drop you ammo. And you need to pay attention to your health. It will not regenerate by yourself, you need to remember that. Unless you will use a vampire weapon. Vampire weapon is a decent option. I just run away. And that's the problem. Okay, vampire weapon. You will do less damage, but it's very unlikely that you will die. What's actually a huge benefit. And you will kill him, even if you will do less damage. If you are spec for bloodied, then you will eventually kill him. Although he's tanky. If you are full health, it will be a problem to do damage to him. Full health, I think you will need actually like 8 people, and I cannot turn. Sometimes I can turn, sometimes I cannot when on under effect of this scream. I didn't figure out yet what to do to be able to turn. And vampire will keep me healthy, and it's actually sometimes a good idea to go for a little bit higher health than bloodied and nedrage. Obviously bloodied and nedrage you will have the best damage, but going for slightly higher health increases your chances of survival. And especially if you end up solo, if you die, air will regenerate health, what's really bad. If you regenerate health, that will be really bad. And you need to loot it before you will finish the boss, the Wendigo Colossus. After you kill him, there is no time to loot those spawns. And I almost died. I go into this radiation field and the ceiling is falling down now. And now I died. There's a lot of damage around. If you are not shooting with this vampire weapon, that's not a good idea. And respawn time is going up really quickly, then you cannot die too many times. Some additional tip, you can consider using Born Survival. You see, he healed up. He's full health because I'm solo. Then he's regenerating when I die. And there's a lot of Wendigos. There's not like a couple of them. There are hordes spawning. Good thing is, you can charge your adrenaline. Oh, the ceiling falling down again, but thanks to the vampire weapon, I can actually outheal it. What's not easy to do. And as you can see, he's doing quite crazy amount of damage. And the scream. How to deal with the scream? You can just sit next to the wall and then you will be quite safe. And another tip for you guys. Go and check the area a little bit. Because after the event will be over, you kill the boss, you will need to run away from the mine and there will be a timer. And it's not a long timer, it's easy to get lost in here. The exit is not clearly marked. I will show you where the exit is. Not in here. See, it's easy to get lost, I'm already lost. There is exit, I found it. That, my advice, it's actually really good to fight close to this exit. It allows you to evacuate quickly after you finish the colossal problem fight. And if I'm not mistaken, you can still cripple him. Let me check, because there was a small update on the PTS just at the end of last week. Let's see. Torso, heads. Yeah, his legs are crippled. Yeah, you can cripple him. He will still fight, but after you cripple him, he's not walking so much, not kicking so much, and attacking less often. Then it's definitely beneficial to cripple him. Oh, really? That was a hardcore kick. He took me down in power armor with one kick. One of the reasons for that is I have not a single teammate and I am using empath mutation. And from the far you can see that there is exit sign, but it's definitely not a big and visible sign from afar. If you're farther away, you will barely notice this exit sign. And after successfully killing Earl, you can loot his body. And you don't have too much time. There will be more and more Wendigo spawning, but you need to go towards this exit. You need to run, and it's actually quite interesting run. Everything is exploding. There is more Wendigo coming out from every corner. Although I do not advise fighting them too much and looting them. Rather running away is an option. Although, if the recent changes that I observe are true, it looks like even if you die in here, you will indeed spawn outside of the mine and you will lose some of the reward, but the key rewards you will get. Like, even if you do not loot the trunk, the cursed weapons, you will get them. Because I died last time and I got my cursed weapon. Otherwise, when you run back when you started, this room is totally broken and you can enter it thanks to that. And go for this loot trunk. There is your additional loot that you can get. And there is no cursed weapon. Again, then chance for a cursed weapon is not too high. And after that, you can see I still have 40 seconds and there is still holotape that I should pick up, but I don't want to do anything connected with the lore. And we can get out to Appalachia. And now we are out and there is a 3-star guarantee item that I just got. And there are more standard rewards that we'll see on the screen right now. It's not all guarantee. Some of those rewards are guaranteed, some of them are random, as usually. And Colossus Plushie, I think, is a guarantee. And if you notice, there is 8 treasure nodes for this event. then if you need treasure notes, that can be the best source, but only if you have teammates armed to their teeth, and that can take this even rather quickly. As Wendigo Colossus is way tankier than Scourge Beast Queen. That's what you need to know. And I didn't get any cursed weapon this time, but that's okay. It's not a guarantee, and only pickaxe is actually worth it, and as you can see, you cannot re-enter the mine after you get removed from the event. Either you fail it or you complete it, you cannot get back in. This is always closed. The entrance is full of rubbles and you cannot get in again. You can get in only when event is active. And now we succeeded, then event is not active anymore. And I still have this marker to pick up the holotape, but if you want to pick up your holotape, you can do it as well, only during the event. After event, there is no way of going back in. As you can see, no way. You cannot get back in. And is it possible to solo it? Definitely, it is possible. But it will cost you a lot of resources, most likely. It take you a lot of time. Then I will not advise going solo versus Wendigo Colossus. I will advise at least like 4 people, well armed, preferably low health builds. Bloodied builds, unfortunately, bloodied builds are promoted everywhere, including this event. I cannot do anything about that, guys. If you don't like that everyone is running bloodied build, that's actually should be directed towards the development team and Bethesda, not me. I have no influence over that. And yes, everything that's added to the game promote bloodied builds. That's true. Apart from one thing, that they remove the auto health regeneration. Then that's one thing that is against bloodied builds, but you can just grab a vampire weapon and go low health with vampire weapon, or equip like a born survivor. I actually, if you have a lot of stim packs, I actually advise using born survivor. Even if you are low health, it will consume one stim pack every 20 seconds. But if you craft like a lot of diluted ones, then that's actually good. It will save you a lot of death. And if you have at least one teammate with you that can revive you and hopefully is running empath, if you are both running empath and you are together, then you're fine. If you go with your friend, just 2 people, both bloodied build, full damage, you know what you are doing, you are fine with this event. If you are a full health build, even 4 people full health will struggle to finish this event on time, and it will be even more expensive to finish it than if you go as a bloodied build. And as always, guys, if you have any questions related to this event, let me know in comment section. And of course, in future I will be testing different build on the Colossus, and we'll see what works and what doesn't, and how this event will progress and what will be the meta. We don't know the meta yet because it's the new event starting tomorrow. Then good luck, everyone. And as always, thank you a lot for watching, and see you in the next one.